Way. We don't need to talk about it because we're going to live the game. The final game of Heat 2 about to get underway. The last match on the main stage today. Who will be our top 12 and who will go home? We find out now. Nobody knows.
I guess we'll see here.
A little nursery rhyme action.
I'm impressed.
Thank
yeah,
you.
Always impressed.
But I'm not a rapper.
I don't believe that in the slightest. Yeah. We see here pretty even spread of players. Curious to see what drop locations are going to be intensely occupied.
Let's get into the action, folks. As Zedrin flying all the way over, did PRX just take damage? I think he got tagged from the island. So PRX is landing with already less than 90 health. That's got to be quite frustrating. A look over all the beautiful lands of Fortnite Battle Royale. 100 players alive. Who will be the first to drop?
I would assume not all your worries is there's probably other teams waiting down below. Crispy and Wish kind of navigating through here, smacking all the little structures, trying to get the materials again. Jay Truth and Wilds, 21 HP, gets the knockdown on Dark Ops, gets picked by Fariko from above. Continuing from Wilds, pushing, he's got to try and save his teammate.
Oh, Truth is instantly gone.
Double barrel, only 7 damage from the double.
No.
Indeed.
And there's Fariko, the quick builds, the box, and he's got his teammate back. Got up 2 early limbs there. Now over to Wishy Luck and Crispy, who already won. They won the Make It Rain earlier on, right? So they've already placed
they did
and
indeed.
Earned themselves some money. But they're going to look for more
down
now.
There. Johnny K floating away, leaving Tantric behind. But the elimination finishing off, Wishy Luck there. Looks like Johnny's going down to Greasy, which is occupied. Hogman to chop it down. So it's demanded his teammate down there. So you have to see what happens. So those two, those almost 2.5 teams end up running into each other. Wish and Crispy now able to just farm up top here pretty comfortably.
There's a lot of mats up here.
Oh, yeah. Austin Crimson, that's a really wide split between the two.
But Crimson can just, I was about to say, Crimson can just dive off the top and just like that. Oh, he wants this fight right
Very
away.
Very aggressive, potentially too aggressive at this point, unless Austin's going to push in underneath him almost immediately. This is a build fight that
he's done for.
Didn't really want to take. He's got the grappler. He could sneak his way out. He's trying to build against his opponent, get the shotgun shot off, and then replace the wall, but it doesn't pay off. Austin.
Dude, Zexro and Vinny are just good fighters. They're just good in getting in scrappy battles and coming out on top. That's another time where Vinny, I think Vinny and Zexro have had some sort of some amount of a limbs off the break of every single game up to this point. Vinny's rewarded with a med kit. Even though Poach said they wanted to change things up or they were going to go for it, I feel like they haven't really changed much about their gameplay to this point. Still zero limbs. This is one of those things, Lupo, where I think a lot of the success we've seen from players is them getting in those early fights in the game. Not going late game with zero eliminations.
If they, yeah, exactly. If they're waiting to late game to start making some moves, I feel like it's, even in terms of mindset, if you are not in the I'm about to engage someone mindset, you can get caught off guard by people very easily. If you've just been taking it slow, yep. taking it easy the entire time, I mean, it's great. Like you said, if they haven't fought anybody yet, we'll see if they're prepared or not. Thresh and Java down here, the edge of paradise, kind of going back and forth.
Going for these speed edits there with the first couple, but
double clingers there trying to drop some structure, knock the wall out and see if it gets some form of exposure, but the rift to go comes in big right there. The escape for Thresh, the team that Thresh and Jamba were trying to push on there.
Look at the little ants down low.
Just following them in, man.
Now it's Turkey Lips and Outlet on the low ground. They want to fight Thresh and Especially that we're going for it. There's players all around too. They're easily going to get third party in this engagement as well. Yep, you see the shots coming in from range. Thresh popping that glide to redeploy. Will he get the trap? Oh, I thought he had him trapped right there to pop the spike trap on down, which would have one-shotted that player, but he doesn't actually get it off in time. Jarvis is getting shredded. Jarvis is not. I can tell you right now that they're regretting this, Lupo.
Outlet, Turkey Lips there. Both very low. It might be a 2v1, but based on HP, little warehouse there. So Wishy Luck and Crispy earlier a replay. See Elim on static. After the knockdown, Chug Jug drop inside.
Oh, and that trap was just on the other side of that
just
wall.
Just the next structure.
You could tell they just couldn't. They had to make sure they got that Elim before they walked out in there. Once you get on one of these hills, you go ahead and just start building on up.
You see the V-Caliber looks like secures an Elim on Top Gun. Way outside the zone, he's trying to pop that medkit to stay alive. Lassius moving in. Turkey Lips you see on the north side. Caliber's teammate Nolan still alive as well. Lassius, the zone, 5 damage, 8 HP left, and he's just trying to build himself into a box any later he can, and Tomo from above catches him off guard.
Tomo now down and immediately, hands to the eyes like, no.
Yep.
That was our moment there where we needed points in this game. Not going to happen now. Choppa down, still hanging out. As he's just staying hidden. Enigma and Fuzzy. Just to the edge of this. Oh, they had someone right in front, and you saw. He saw the same thing that I saw. It was like a brief moment where they had the drop, but instant reactions. How quick those walls went up. The shot doesn't connect, and now they'll have to just go back in hibernation and wait and see when their next opportunity to push on out is.
That's funny. He puts down the heavy sniper, even though we've seen it as a very powerful utility from other teams, because he had no ammunition left for it. At that point, he's just taking up a slot in the inventory. Near Vivid, kind of a check to see if anybody's hiding in that box. But he's got enough space. He can just kind of wiggle around on the bottom. Freaks and Feet taking up Cub Smiles. Ball finalizing that elimination.
Inching here closer and closer.
Here's your list. Two teams sit on 5 elims total this game. Tomo and Rizar.
And Vinny and Zexro.
Every time. Those guys, for me,
I think are my favorite players of today.
Oh, yeah.
The fact that they are always high up on the elims tally. And this is a big game right now for the Sentinel duo. They're actually still alive. Remember, 2 of the games so far.
They went out.
They were out instantly.
Top 90 people.
So they're having to, like, everyone else had 4 games to get their points. With how their games went, they basically have had 2.
Exactly.
So we're going to keep an eye on them as well to see if they can bounce into the top 12. Because I don't think they're in it right now.
These guys, little edits, looking for window peaks. Surprising a little bit to me that he's keeping the window open that long because somebody might have an angle potentially. There we go. That shot. White damage, no shield on target. He's looking for just the last push as the storm moves. Gently closer, there it is. Trying to go for the shots as that rotation happens. Gonna take another one there. Gets the knockdown on Vinny. Which means Zexro is probably not far behind. We'll see if Vivid can secure.
They need this so bad, man. They need this so bad. Oh, gosh. That was a sniper bullet that also flew by right there. Their first elim of the game. They just got an awesome next zone as well. If you see, it's right behind them. Poach realizing that right away. Poach, one of the best at these kind of crawl builds. Utilizing all these one-by-ones, getting ready to move on out. Poach, about 900 total materials. Vivid, right next to him. Wait, are they going to try to bounce with this crater? Did you just see what was right on the other side of that wall? I believe they have a crater right there. Can they hit it? I'm wondering if they just wait for the zone and then just bounce right off that. Oh, what? Look,
right,
it did hit him, but it's not what he wanted to have happen, I'll tell you that.
It looks like he covered it up just to prevent any kind of unpredictable movement out of that.
And this is the beauty. They're going back through their tunnels. They've already had all of this claimed. Look, still, they haven't had to spend a single material. Now they'll begin to go. Freezy down. Colton down. Players dropping left and right.
Landjock picking up an Elim in the feet as well. Tom and Rizar.
Again, they're having to use so many mats for these moves. Now it looks like he's confident enough to stop for a second, maybe look for a quick peek. His teammate does go down. Poach just got knocked out and killed by a trap. Poach just got eliminated by a trap.
It's like his Razor's trap, but Vivid picks up the Elim on
Oh
Raz
no.
As well.
Poach is gone. Vivid now, the last hope. What can he do? He's got 2 Elims. He needs to get another. He's done. He's done. This is how it ends. I don't think Vivid and Poach are making it to Sunday.
I don't think that they are. Now we have Animal and Grus still here from Sentinel, trying to move their way in. In the safe zone, 28 left and 44 seconds on the circle move. Just kind of biding their time and structures they built up. Not a whole ton of materials left, 250. So 25 builds left for Animal and counting as he builds his way out this little sky base here, this tunnel. 14 builds left and shots are coming from the east side. An adjacent team right there pushing up right in front, blocks him off of the wall, but his teammate closes him off behind.
Does his teammate have extra materials for him?
At this point, either they don't have the time or there's no mats left. Shots as a pair drop in directly on top of him. Does have the trap, but he doesn't put it down.
Oh, gosh. This is some panic right here. I can promise you that. Animal now trying to move forward. You see Bald gets eliminated there. Poach, this is how he went down. No. Oh, no. The player dropped right on him.
Razru fell directly into the box. A very quick trap placement. Blood's still alive here. 9 HP. 3 traps. He's got a grapple, which we've seen late game is very important. 33 seconds on this circle move. We've got 12 players left. The final match of Heat 2. No medkits. A pair of
this
epic
is like
ARs.
Remember, this is like the Tfue game where he had 19 health in these final zones. Like, he just needs to be a ghost and try to get top 3. No! Animals. No. Will he make it in?
1 HP and gets caught.
I thought he actually made it until Salt shoots him in the back. 8 players now remaining. Chute is trying to break through these metal walls, trying to just continue to navigate. It's so tough when he doesn't own any of this. Bog is popping a medkit in the zone. You've got Vape Jesus and Pain. Oh, if Vape Jesus and Pain lose this, I'd be shocked. They're on the high ground. They are just chilling out right now.
No materials left.
Yep.
In Pain's inventory. That's why they're going to have to drop down in here. And
he's going
hopefully
for
can
it.
Catch this player
landing
off guard.
Right on one.
Doesn't see it. Doesn't hear the glider, apparently. Oh! The shot to the face.
A quick crack right there on the drop. Yet again, he's playing the low ground. Vape Jesus playing the high ground. They've got everything they needed. Another elimination comes on in. More players dropping on down. The rockets from above. It's all collapsing on the enemies now. They've got the med kit too. Pain and Vape Jesus. Can they do it right now? Vape Jesus gets knocked by a fall. Pain on the low ground. Could it all go spiraling? And there it is. The shot from Pain. As it's another point for the elimination. Wow, in the final moments. That was Blood. Remember how weak he was? Vape Jesus.
Vape on the way down is taking shots to try and get the Elim of Blood. Look
yes.
at the HP left there. I don't blame him. Just trying to secure one hit there, and Pain gets that jump shot with a shotgun
what a
on Blood right inside
is.
The circle.
Let's see it again from Pain's perspective. Look, two Elims at this point. Not only does a victory royale earn them one, but Pain now realizing the nerves that comes in the shot.
The reaction there, absolutely perfect.
Brilliantly done, and that is a perfect example, no matter.
Take a look at this, Heat 2 standings. These are the finalists going into the grand finals. With that performance, Pain and Vape Jesus steal the first place spot. Unbelievable, these are your top 12 heading into grand finals. People in the venue, you're not yelling loud enough. No, that's not loud enough. That's closer. I'll take that. It's been a long day. I'll take that. You guys have been, you know, you've been yelling a lot. These are the Heat 1 finalists. So these are earlier on in the day. These are the 12 moving on to the grand finals where Dr. Lupo and Courage will be casting that game on Sunday. We see Cloaksy and Tfue right there at the top. 15 points. Just setting the bar. Guys. We hope you have enjoyed all of the